Miss Rachel. Most welcome.
Thank you.
You can go on.
Bonjour.
Hello, everybody. So my name is Rachel Villebrun. So I hope that you will all enjoy my presentation today. And I'm going to start right now. So I'm going to minimize this. Good. So the basic French language. So who am I? What about me? Qui suis-je? So my name is Rachel. I am 26 years old. I am located in Mauritius. And I am a native French and English speaker. I actually have nearly 5 years of experience in the field of online teaching as well as live teaching, both children and adults. So I have been graduated in 2016 in the field of education. And my mission is to improve your language level and knowledge because we learn every day. So I'll say it in French now. Je m'appelle Rachel, j'ai 26 ans. Je suis située à Maurice. Je suis de langue maternelle française et anglaise, bilingue à l'écrit et à l'oral. Donc j'en ai fait près de 5 ans d'expérience dans le domaine de l'enseignement en ligne ainsi que l'enseignement direct. J'ai été graduée en 2016 à l'Université de Maurice. Et ma mission est d'améliorer votre niveau, vos connaissances linguistiques. Nous apprenons tous les jours. So what I've just said is the same in French. Just for you to hear a little bit about my accent. So what are we going to learn today? So we start with a very brief introduction about French. Alphabets, les alphabets, numbers, les nombres, colors, les couleurs, family members, les membres de la famille, and everyday expressions, donc les citations, les dialogues de tous les jours. Next. Some introduction. French is based on the Latin alphabet. There are 26 letters in the French alphabet, 6 vowels and 20 consonants. And it's just like in the English language. So let's start. We have 27 in all, but in English it's A, B, C, D, E, F, etc. So in French it will be A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, et Z. So today we'll talk about only 5 of them, the first 5 letters of the alphabet. So the first one, let's start. The pronunciation is A. In English, it's A. In French, it's A. Like, for example, une araignée. The first one, une araignée. It's a spider. A spider is said as une araignée in French. Donc, une araignée. A. Araignée. Now, the plane. It said un avion. Avion. This is a fruit. I don't know if you know about it. It's an avocado. And an avocado is said as avocat. Un avocat. Donc, araignée, araignée, avion, avocat. And it's written this way in caps lock. Donc, the little one is this one. It's like in English. So, A. A becomes A in French. Next. Now the B, like in English. B become B. Pronunciation B. So, you have here a baby. In French, we say un bébé. So, un is one. Et baby, un bébé. Un bébé. Un bébé. It's just like we repeat the B in French. Bé, bébé. A baby, un bébé. Now, this is a banana. And in French, we say une banane. Banane. Banana becomes banane. Now the butter. The butter becomes une bouteille. B, bouteille. B, bouteille. So, bébé, banane, bouteille. In caps lock, donc, it's like that. Just like in French. Every letter in English is written the same way as in French. So, bébé, banane, bouteille. Now, let's go on with the C. Pronunciation, C. C. Oops. Right. Donc, C in French, C en français. C. This is a crab. In French, we say un crabe. Un crabe. I was at the beach and I saw a crab. J'étais à la plage et j'ai vu un crabe. C'est crabe. Vegetables, carrots. So, for lunch, I ate carrots. Donc, une carotte. C'est carotte. Une carotte. Donc, this is a calculator in French. So, in my exam, I use my calculator twice. Donc, dans mon examen, j'ai utilisé une calculatrice deux fois. Donc, une calculatrice et calculator, une calculatrice. C'est calculatrice. So, it's the thing here. Now the D, pronounce, donc, day, pronunciation, day. Donc, day, D becomes day in French. Un docteur, it's a doctor. A doctor, a doctor, it's pronounced the same way, almost. Doctor, doctor, doctor. Day, doctor. Now the dolphin. A dolphin, un dauphin, un dauphin, des dauphins. Now a donut, yummy, donut, un donut, it's the same way, but it's not written the same. We use the D still. A donut in English, un donut, donut, donut. Donut. It's the D. Now the E. Pronunciation E. E becomes E in French. E. And sometimes you have an accent on it. So all the vowels can have accent on it. So this is an example. You have an accent on the E. So it's not E, it becomes E. This one, E to E. This one, E. So it changed the word. Un éléphant. E becomes E with accent. Un éléphant. Éléphant. Elephant. An elephant in English? In French? Un éléphant. Now, un enfant. Un enfant means a kid, a child. A child, a kid. Children, des enfants, children. A child, un enfant. So you have un enfant here, you have two enfants, donc deux enfants. E. You have also the word élève, étudiant, which means student. Look, you see here, there's a lot of students here and they are learning. Here's the teacher. Students, teacher, and the teacher is l'enseignant, un enseignant. Teacher in English, enseignant in French. Now, where are they in a class? Yes, class is said class in French, but we are on the E word. So the class is found in school. A school is une école en français. So they are in a school. Une école. Ils sont dans une école. They are in a school. Ils sont dans une école. École. The E word. So you have un éléphant, un enfant, a child, un élève, un étudiant, synonyms of student. Whoops. Un enseignant, a teacher, or a teacher or a tutor, and une école, a school. Here you have an envelope. That's not written, sorry. An envelope. An envelope in French means envelope. Envelope. It's written the same way, but we have an E at the end. Envelope. Next. So now you have a little video about ABCD in French. So enjoy quickly.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Et maintenant je les connais, toutes les lettres de l'alphabet. Encore une fois, vous chantez avec moi? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P,
Q, R,
S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Maintenant je les connais, toutes les lettres de l'alphabet.
All the letters of alphabet. That's written here. So, numbers, les chiffres in French. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, the first one is a 1. 1 is 1 in French. 1. Donc là, c'est un appartement. An apartment. A house, if you want. So, un appartement. Une maison. Good. 1, 1. 1. U-N. 1. The 2 now. 2 is equal to 2 in French. 2. 1, 2. Here you have 2 umbrellas. 2 umbrellas. 2 parapluies. 2 parapluies. 2 umbrellas. 2 parapluies. 2. D E U X. D E U X. 2. Good. Now the 3. 3 is 3 in French. 3. 1, 2, 3. 3. T-R-O-I-S. T-R-O-I-S. 3. Here you can see 3 books. Ici, vous pouvez voir trois livres. Il y a trois livres. There are three books. Il y a trois livres. Books, livres. Livre, it starts with an L. Livre. So, trois. Three. Trois. Next. A four now. Quatre. Sorry. Quatre. Four. Quatre. Two. U. A. T. R. E. Quatre. So here you can see four bicycles. Quatre bicyclettes. Four bicycles. Quatre bicyclettes. So bicyclette starts with a B. So four is quatre in French. Quatre. Un, deux, trois, quatre. It's written the same way. Cinq maintenant. Now. Cinq. Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq. Cinq. C-I-N-Q. 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 Cinq. Five. So here you can see five toothbrushes. In French, we say cinq brosses à dents. Brosse, brush, à dents, for teeth. Brosse à dents. Brosse à dents. Brosse, it's a brush. Dents, it's a teeth in French. Brosse à dents. Brosse à dents. Cinq brosse à dents. Cinq. Six. Now, it says six. Donc, you remove the X in French. Donc, you remove the X in English. You put an S. Six. You hear the X. Six in English, six becomes six. You remove the X, you put an S for the ear. Six in English, six in French. Six. Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six. So here you have six balls. Là, vous pouvez voir six ballons. Donc le six, on n'entend pas le X. We don't hear the X before certain words. For example, 36, il y a 36 chemins. Sometimes you hear the X, sometimes you don't. Donc, 6. 6. Now the 7. 7. 7. S-E-P-T. S-E-P-T. 7. In French, you can't hear the P. You can't hear the P. Set. It's like a set of crunches of the size. So a set. Set. Ici, vous pouvez voir sept peluches. Here you can see seven teddies. Seven teddies. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six, sept. Sept. Cute ones. So you gotta be hungry now. So eight. Eight, c'est huit. Huit en français. In French. Huit. H-U-I-T. H-U-I-T. Huit. Dans cette pizza, il y a huit tranches. In this pizza, you have eight slices. Eight slices. Dans cette pizza, vous avez huit tranches. So, tranches, slices. Vous avez huit tranches. Huit. Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six, sept, huit. Next. The nine one. Neuf. Nine. Neuf. N-E-U-F. N-E-U-F. Nine. So you can see here, nine dogs. Nine dogs. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Nine, neuf, un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six, sept, huit, neuf. Il y a 9 chiens. There are 9 dogs. Dogs, chiens. Un chien, deux chiens. Ten now, the last one. So, we say 10, and in French, we say 10. In French, we say 10. 10. D-I-X. 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 So here you can see 10 chocolates. 10 chocolates. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 et 10. Il y a 10 chocolats. There are 10 chocolates. Now we'll look at this little video of numbers. Numbers in French. Maintenant, on va voir cette petite vidéo sur les nombres, les chiffres en français. Voilà.
Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six, sept, huit, neuf, dix. Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six, sept, huit, neuf, dix.
Le 1 se porte très bien. Le 1 se porte très bien. Et après le 1, il y a quel chiffre?
Le 2.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
On va le revoir. I'm going to repeat it.
Le 1 se porte très bien. Le 1 se porte très bien. Et après le 1, il y a quel chiffre?
Le 2.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
So in this video, they're saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So after the 1, which one do you have? We have the 2. That's what they say. So, le 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 et 10. Alors, what is your favorite number? Quel est ton chiffre préféré? Donc,
you can unmute your mic and share your answers. Miss Bushra, can you share your answer? What's your favorite number? Quel est ton chiffre préféré?
I will not be able to see the message. So,
Miss Alice, can you share your answer?
What is your favorite number? Quel est ton chiffre préféré? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you will write your favorite number in French and you will keep it in mind. So you will be able to say your favorite number in French.
I prefer 5.
5. C-I-N-Q. 5. C-I-N-Q. But it's my favorite number too.
Great.
I was born on the 5th December.
Me too.
5th December?
No, 5th May.
Ah, okay.
Préfère 8.
Ah, mais c'est bien le 8. 8. H-U-I-T. 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 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Encore d'autres réponses? Over answers?
Si, I can try. Mon chiffre préféré est le 6.
Ah, très bien. It was a perfect grammar. Donc, ton chiffre préféré est le 6. Your favorite number is the 6. Perfect. So,
great, Miss Alice.
Yes, perfect. 6, S-I-A. S-I-A.
Balraj. Yeah. Balraj, give it a try. Miss Bushra. Miss Hidayah. Can you give it a try?
Hedia Riehi. Alors, mon chiffre préféré, c'est 8.
Excellent. The accent is wow. Okay. Good.
Great.
Nice to hear. It's nice. Very nice to hear.
Welcome.
Merci.
Another one? You're welcome. That's all? So, mine is the 5. The 5 and the 12. So, it's 2 numbers after 10. 12. 10. 11, 12, because I was born on the 5th December. So we continue?
Great, let's continue.
Thank you for all the, your answers. So now we talk about the colors. The colors in French, couleur. So you add the E, you remove the O, you add EU and you add a U here. So color, C-O-L-L-O-R becomes couleur. Color, couleur. Donc là, on va avoir les couleurs. We're going to see the colors. So everybody who likes to draw must know about the colors. You have the primary colors and the secondary colors. So for today, we'll look on at only the primary colors. Let's go. So you have all these colors, white, gray, black, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, brown, pink, blanc, gris, noir, rouge, orange, jaune, vert, bleu, mauve. So some people, it depends on the range of the purple. Brown, marron, pink, rose. So for all these colors, you have a lot of a range. So here for purple, you have two types, a lot of types of purple. You have violet, you have mauve, you have a lot. So you can see violet here or mauve. Like here, you can see blue or turquoise. That's it. Let's see about the primary colors. So we start with the flag of my country, red, blue, yellow, green. So the red, rouge. Red, rouge. Moi, j'aime la couleur rouge. I like the red color. The color red. Rouge. Red, R-E-D, becomes rouge. R-O-U-G-E. Rouge. Rouge comme une pomme. Red like an apple. An apple is a pomme. Une pomme. Croquer dans une pomme. An apple. And you have tomato, tomatoes. Sorry, tomatoes. So rouge comme une tomate, red like a tomato. Rouge, rouge, pomme, apple, tomate, tomato. Pomme, tomate, rouge. Maintenant le bleu. Le bleu. 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 Blue in English, bleu in French. Bleu is written, they have the same letters, but the E and the U are misplaced. They change place. Blue, B-L-U-E, becomes B-L-E-U. Bleu, B-L-E-U. Bleu comme la mer. Blue like the sea. Bleu comme la mer. Tu as les yeux bleus comme la mer. You have blue eyes like the sea. Oh, you have blue eyes like the sky. Bleu comme le ciel. Ciel. Si, c'est mer. Ciel is the sky. Bleu comme le ciel. Blue like the sky. Bleu. Now today the sky is gray on my side. and it's raining a lot since yesterday. So jaune now, jaune, jaune, yellow. You can guess? You can guess it? Jaune, jaune like the sun, yellow like the sun, jaune comme le soleil, soleil, a beautiful soleil. Can you see? I searched for a very big soleil. So this is a soleil and it's jaune, jaune. Now you have bananas. And bananas, banane, like you saw. Jaune comme une banane. So the banana is yellow, yellow like a banana, yellow, yellow. Now the green one, green, vert, vert, vert comme la forêt, green like the forest. Donc forêt and forest are written almost the same way, but we have an S in English. Here you don't have the S, but we have a hat on the O, so it's an accent. You have a hat here, forêt. So it don't usually change the pronunciation in French, but it's written better. Forêt, forêt, forest. Donc, like you see, the forest is green. It's all green with all its nature. Vert comme la forêt, green like the forest. Vert comme des légumes verts, green like the green vegetables. Green vegetables. I don't know about you, but I like to eat vegetables. Oh, I like to eat everything. So here are broccolis. Broccolis. Des brocolis en français. So it's the accent that we use to differentiate from French and English. Broccoli, broccoli. Bro becomes broccoli in French. Here you can see a pear, une poire, raisin, grapes, avocado, avocat, pomme, apple, and broccoli, etc. So you have peas, les petits pois, green vegetables, vert, comme des légumes verts. The rose now, rose, the color rose. Donc, pink. Pink becomes rose. Rose. Rose comme une fleur. Pink like a flower. And ironically, this flower's name is rose. So you have the flower Margarita, the flower tulip. This is a flower rose. It's its name. The flower rose. Rose comme une fleur. Rose comme une barbe à papa. Donc là, c'est la barbe à papa. Une barbe à papa, c'est the cotton candy, the pink cotton candy. Who likes to eat the cotton candy? Put on up your speaker, your micro. Who likes cotton candy? Nobody? That's very sweet. So this is the rose, the color rose, pink, rose. R-O-S-E, rose. It's also a name, like every name flower that we give to our children. Yes, Margarita, rose. Now, what's your favorite color? What's yours? So, then say it in French. Quelle est ta couleur préférée? Maintenant, dis-le en français. Donc, je vais rapidement le dire en français. I will rapidly say it in French first. Then you tell me about yours, your favorite. Jaune, jaune. Vert, bleu. Mauve, orange. Orange, rouge, rouge, orange. Marron, noir, gris, blanc. Jaune, orange, rouge. Vert, bleu, mauve, blanc, gris, noir, marron. Allez-y. Farah, can you help me?
I will start, actually, to encourage others. I will start, je préfère vert.
Ouais, c'est bien le vert, comme tu aimes la nature, you like the nature.
Exactly.
Je préfère rouge.
Rouge comme la tomate ou la pomme. Rouge comme la tomate ou la pomme, la tomato over apple.
Comme la tomate.
Do you know that the tomato is a fruit and a vegetable too?
Oui.
Yeah.
Très bien. And anyone else?
Yes.
Yes. Mon couleur préférée est bleu.
Donc, ma couleur préférée.
Ma couleur préférée.
Et le bleu. Très bien. Très bon.
Bleu comme le ciel.
Comme le ciel ou bleu comme la mer. Oui.
Comme la mer.
Avoir les yeux bleus. Moi, j'ai les yeux marron. Marron clair. Brown. Light brown.
Je préfère jaune.
Le jaune comme le soleil ou comme la banane?
Comme le soleil.
Comme le soleil, très bien. Mais je crois que tu as pris mon soleil. Il n'y a pas de soleil chez moi. You stole my sun. Good, très bien, perfect. So, I like all the colors, but particularly the red and the black. So, are we continue? Now,
j'aime toutes les couleurs et j'adore la couleur rouge.
Rouge, oui, très bien. Il y a aussi le rose, hein? Il y a aussi le rose, le pink.
Oui, j'adore la couleur rouge, couleur de sang.
Ah oui, j'ai évité de mettre la couleur du sang, par contre. Good, very good. You like the red color. Perfect. Nobody likes the white color? No? White like the snow. Brown like chocolate. Donc, blanc comme la neige. Snow, neige. Blanc comme la neige. Marron comme le chocolat. Brown like chocolate. No? No chocolate? Okay, so the red, the green, the vert, le rouge, le jaune. On va poursuivre. Continue. Les membres de la famille maintenant. The family members. My family. Ma famille. My becomes ma. My. Family. Famille. You remove a Y, you put a double L-E. Famille. Ma famille, ta famille. Sa famille, famille. Donc, this picture is an extended family. You have the children, les enfants, the parents, the uncle, I think, l'oncle, les parents, la maman, le papa, les grands-parents, the grandparents, les grands-parents. Donc, on va avoir une famille nucléaire, the nuclear family, the very simple family members. So, you have the mother. My mother. My mother is in the kitchen. Ma mère est dans la cuisine. Mère. Mother, come help me. Maman. Ou mère. So you can say mère ou maman. Mère. So one is formal, one is informal. So mère is informal. You can say mom in English and maman in French, but mère is the mostly used. Mère, mother. So in French, ma mère, my mother in English. Now, the father. My father is at work right now. Mon père est au travail maintenant. My father, père. So, mère, père. The only difference is the P and the M. P M. Mother, father, they both end with a T-H-E-R. So, mère, père. Ma sœur et mon frère. Ma sœur, my sister. My sister is very beautiful. Ma sœur est très jolie. My sister is very beautiful. Ma sœur est très jolie. Ma sœur, M-A-S-O-E-U-R. Sœur, sister. Mon frère maintenant. My brother is very annoying. He annoys me every time. Mon frère est très ennuyant. Il m'agace tout le temps. Mon frère, frère. Brother, frère. Ma sœur, mon frère. How many brothers? A little quiz. How many brothers and sisters do you have? Combien de frères et de sœurs as-tu? Donc, tout d'abord, dites-moi, c'est quoi ce dessin animé avec ce frère et ses deux sœurs? Do you know what is this cartoon? What is the name of the tune?
Oui, les Simpsons.
C'est l'un des préférés, my favorite. Yeah, oh, I know, I am 26. But I like to watch this show. J'adore regarder ce dessin animé.
Miss Rachel, can you repeat the numbers so that they can remember the numbers? Yes.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
Yes, of course.
Just to remember can answer the question, combien de sœurs?
Of course, yeah, I understand. Understand, I'll get you. So, how many brothers and sisters do you have? How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's a lot. 8, 9, 10. J'ai 3 frères, moi, personnellement. Personally, I have 3 brothers. Personnellement, j'ai 3 frères. Personally, I have 3 brothers. Personnellement, in French. Personnellement, I have 3 brothers. Donc, j'ai 3 frères. Personnellement, j'ai 3 frères. 3 frères. J'ai 3 frères qui m'agacent à la maison. I have 3 brothers who annoys me at home. Et j'ai une sœur. I have a sister. I have 3 brothers and 1 sister. J'ai 3 frères et une sœur. Et je suis la plus petite. I am the youngest. I am the Benjamin. Je suis la plus petite. Je suis la Benjamin. À votre tour. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3. Vas-y, go on. Dis-moi. How many brothers and sisters? Combien de frères et de sœurs as-tu?
J'ai une sœur.
Une sœur, oui. Et un frère, pas de frère?
Non. J'ai un frère.
Un frère. Donc, la première a une sœur. Maintenant, toi, tu as un frère. C'est tout?
Oui.
Et il t'agace? Does he annoys you? Mind you, but it's me who annoys them now. When I was little, they were annoying me. Now I annoy them. Quand j'étais petite, ils m'agaçaient. Maintenant, c'est moi qui les agace. I annoy them now. And anybody else?
Yes, Miss Ulfa, you want to share your answer?
Yeah.
J'ai un frère.
Ah, un frère.
Et il est grand, il est petit. Older than you or younger?
Petit.
Petit. Ok. Toi, tu es la grande.
Oui.
Donc, tu as un petit frère. Donc, vous êtes à deux. Deux enfants. Two children. Good. Très bien. You're not alone. Tu n'es pas seule. Tu peux jouer avec lui.
That's all. So I am actually 26 and my oldest brother is 38. 36, 38. Yes. So I will continue then. Everyday expressions in French. So what are the useful expressions to learn in French that every French speaker must say at least, like the bonjour, yeah, hello. So 12 phrases in French, 12 phrases en anglais, en français, désolé. Salut, hello, salut, salut. Donc, like you can see, you have bonjour, salut. It's the same thing, but one is more formal, is more formal. Both are informal, but this one is more formal. This one is informal. But this one can be used in the formal way and in the informal way. Good morning, bonjour, bonjour. Salut, salut, hello, salut, bonjour, salut. Now, a goodbye. Au revoir, au revoir. Goodbye, au revoir. Excusez-moi, excuse me. I didn't hear. Excusez-moi, je n'ai pas entendu. Excusez-moi. Excuse me, please, excuse me. Comment vas-tu? How are you? How are you today? I'm fine. Comment vas-tu? Je vais bien, merci. Donc, comment vas-tu? Comment vas-tu? Merci. Thank you. Merci. Merci. Thank you. Merci. M-E-R-C-I. Merci. I love you. Je t'aime. So I love you all for being present here. Je t'aime. Je t'aime. I love you. Je t'aime. Je t'aime. Please. Please. S'il vous plaît. S'il vous plaît. S'il vous plaît. So it's said in three, with three words. It's not optional. Please is s'il vous plaît. S'il vous plaît. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Pardon. So it's like excuse me. Excuse me. Excusez-moi. Can I pause? I'm sorry. Can I pause? It's used in the same way. There's no great difference. Pardon. Pardon. Pardon, j'ai fait du bruit. I'm sorry. I made too much noise. Pardon. Enchanté. Nice to meet you. Hello. Hello. Hello, I'm Rachel. Hello. Nice to meet you. Enchanté. Nice to meet you. Je vais bien, merci.
Hello. Thank you. Hello.
Flash for today.
Hello. Donc, we say it in English first, Farah, quickly.
I want to say merci beaucoup.
Merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup. Thanks a lot. Merci beaucoup. Merci. Hein? You're welcome. Your welcome is de rien.
De rien.
De rien. De rien. Yes, I know it in Spanish too, de nada. Don't we not speak Spanish. De rien. You're welcome. De rien. De rien. You're welcome. Alors, enchanté. Nice to meet you. Hello, I am Rachel. Hello, I am Rita. Ah, nice to meet you, Rita. Enchanté, Rita. Donc, c'est enchanté. Nice to meet you. Je vais bien, merci. Comment vas-tu? Comment vas-tu? Je vais bien, merci. How are you? Fine, thank you. How are you? Fine, thank you. Comment vas-tu? Je vais bien, merci. So for those who are not alone, You can practice it with your other half at home. Comment vas-tu? Je vais bien, merci. Alors, the last one. Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. So it's the same. It means the same, but merci, but with more emphasis. So merci is like 100 and merci beaucoup is like 200 of greetings. So thank you, merci, simple one. Merci beaucoup. Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much.
Merci beaucoup, 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 Miss Rachel. Really, it was a very interesting and very engaging webinar or event. I think we like it all, and hopefully we will meet soon with summer camp and with French basics course for kids. Let's now wrap up and to have a resume.
Yeah, so here you see the alphabet.
Our workshop.
I will say it quickly, very briefly. A, B, C, D, E, F, D, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. So you can see on this side how it's pronounced. So you will, it will be easier for you to know how to pronounce it. The colors now: rouge, jaune, bleu, marron, blanc. This is brown actually. Brown, marron, blanc, gris, noir, orange, violet, mauve, vert, rose, pink. La famille, the family. Mère, mother. Père, father. Bébé, baby. Grand-père, grandfather. Grand-mère, grandmother. Oncle. In French, oncle. Mon oncle et ma tante. My aunt and my uncle. Ma tante et mon oncle. Tante. Sœur, frère. Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six, sept, huit, neuf, dix. So you can see between commas how it's pronounced. Like it's here. Deux, trois. That's a little rapid resume of what we have learned today. Have you have a time to take a photo, maybe? Avez-vous eu le temps de prendre une photo?
Of course, many, they have taken many photos of the workshops and the presentation. Merci beaucoup, beaucoup. Thank you so much. Thank you for all the audience, and hope to see you soon with the our French course in the summer camp. Thank you to every and single one who have joined our workshop. And bye-bye for now.
Bye everyone. Au revoir. Bye, and thank you for being present here, and thank you, Bantis, for you organizing it.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Okay. Bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye. Thank you so much.
Bye.